Yes. And again, if you look at the tie, they have a Venezuelan professional footballer in the side playing against Kumasi Asante Kotoko today. Oh, another good stoppage there, Kumasi Asante Kotoko, and they have opportunity to push forward. Jeffy, he switched play. Looking for the referee's call, Jeffy. It's now Sportive. Hamza turns well, finds the ball in. Meha. Ball returned into the half of Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And Kotoko wins a free kick. Another opportunity there for the Tunisian side. Justice play in here, bit into it beautifully there, and it's going to be Tunisian side pushing forward. Kotoko looking to reply quickly. Jenfi, here comes Jordan. Jordan turns well, finds support. Ajman Bedu. It is Blay. Kotoko calming things down now. Habib Mohamed. Okra to Kotoko's Habib, and here they come, Jordan. So it's going to be a long ball forward, looking for the round of Jenfi, couldn't quite find him. It's been difficult for Kotoko to keep control of the ball here. It is Abenge. And two players colliding on each other, nobody trying to find a way to deal with the situation. And now it's going to be Sportive here, looking to experience a very long one. And Kotoko would have Ampim da Costa. One of the sad stories there was the collision there between Abege and Okra in terms of who to handle the ball. I tell you what, there was one huge decision that had to come in from the coach, as in what to do. It's going to be Darwin Gonzalez, the 25-year-old Venezuelan. Here comes Kumasi Asante Kotoko. With some of the pressure, they haven't been that impressive, have they? Even though they lead by a goal to nil, Kotoko haven't been that exclusive with their play. They know that a slim win here wouldn't be the magic. And here comes Jeffy. Turns his man in. Abege here. Abege was looking to hit one. It's been blocked. And Kumasi Asante Kotoko will have justice play in here. Play. And here comes Jeffy. And again, it's been blocked away. Well, Kotoko now with opportunity. Well, that's another player of Tunisia down. Well, they have time now to cool off a little bit. Kumasi Asante Kotoko against Sportive Sahel. This game is turning out to be something else. The Porcupine Warriors will find a way to get in. Oh, the Kumasi Asante got the players have moved into their defensive line. And yes, another Tunisian player still having difficulties and being dealt with. And so Sportive du Sahel, one of the clubs that they picked up a 7-1 win before playing against Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Well, the club was found during a public meeting at the French Tunisian School on Narosi Zarouk Street in Sousse. Jeffy, well played there from him. Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Lead here by goal to nil. Okra. Abege. Another play there from Abege. Looks for another long range. And again, Kumasi Asante Kotoko can't quite get away from Sportive. They picked up possession again. Been that the impressive Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Okra. Abege here. Picks out Jordan. Jordan back to Okra. And Okra again giving the ball away. It's Augustin Okra looking for long range and goes wide. Very experienced player. Tell you what, he was with Kumasi Asante Kotoko some seasons ago and he moved away to Bechem United. Couldn't quite get his form in the club. Found his way in Sudan with Amarek and Al Hilal and then moved to the United States and a bit of a stint there in India. And he's back home here in Ghana playing for his club, Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Augustin Okra, what a player who joined the club and a lot of fans have been pretty much excited about his performance. And here comes Sportive, looking to have another one here. Good play here from Ajman Beru. Jemfi, see where to pick this ball on the line. Good play, Jemfi, but flag up here against Emmanuel Jemfi. Fans disagree with the call from the assistant referee. And Kane Jr. thinks otherwise. Well, it's been Kumasi Asante Kotoko's explosive display here. Here comes the Tunisians. Ball to the near post picked up. It's a long ball forward. Abege is one to chase. Okra cools it down. Blay. Apem da Costa picks up Blay. Okra here. Lovely play. Jordan picks out Abege on the flanks. Kumasi Asante Kotoko looking to keep up possession. Justice Lee picks up another pass here. And again, they have a very poor one there from the former Bindiema defensive midfielder. A lot of space now, and now Sportive here with a chance to look for a strike. Not the best of cover up there from Kumasi Asante Kotoko, but again it has to be pushed away. It's going to be a throw in. Gonzalez there was in to find a way in. Sportive would try to advertise one in. It's going to be a corner kick. It's a good play from Salim. Corner kick taken short here. Oh, Kotoko players to the far post. Brought in, cleared by Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Okra. And he's been fouled. Abega looks to pick up the ball quickly. And Tunisian goes to ground. And Kotoko now beginning to move. A flag off on offside against Richard Arta. Free kick to Sportif du Sahel. And two players of Kotoko, they're clutching on each other. Meher, Jordan, Abege, looking to pick up Arthur. Richard Arthur, Skumasi Asante Kotoko, looking for space. And looks for this one. And Kumasi Asante Kotoko couldn't quite find a way in. But opportunity now for the Porcupine Warriors to find a way to get into a second goal mood. So the fans have been looking forward for that one. Really hasn't come the way they expected though. But Jenfi would feel that these are moments where the team can take advantage of a set piece. Jeffy ball to the far post. And again, it's going to be another ball. Advantage Kumasi Asante Kotoko. They've been piling some bit of pressure. Here they come here with a chance to move forward. Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Another ball to the near post. Yet again, it is going to be a third corner kick in succession for the Porcupine Warriors as they look to unlock the defense again of Etoile Sportif du Sahel for the second goal. Fans are looking for this one. Another ball in here. And Kotoko still struggling. Well, fans are saying that should be a penalty. The Liberian official looks otherwise. Da Costa. Ajman Beru, Abege, it's Kumasi Asante Kotoko, Okra, against the crossbar, and Kotoko not lucky this time, could have been a second for Augustin Okra. What an explosive shot there from Augustin Okra. That would have been one of the remarkable goals there for the Porcupine Warriors, and especially so for Augustin Okra. He was looking for his second. Great effort. Except to say that a crossbar came to his rescue of Etoile Sportif du Sahel. Play. Abege. Oh, lovely, lovely work there. I'm seeing some bit of play, the exciting one from Hamza Lamar. Well, Kumasi Asante Kotoko have lost at home once against teams based in North Africa in the CAF Inter-Club competition. That was in the 2015 CAF Champions League game, and against EL Uma, and Kotoko lost by 2-1 at home. And not the very first time they lost in the month of September. Here comes another ball in, picked up by Felix Sanan looking for Richard Arthur. Oh, there's a header down. Arthur goes in here. Well, he's going to commit a foul. Richard Arthur brings down Hanichi Meher, the left fullback. Well, the fans have been looking forward to an exciting game. Of course, they have the goal to enjoy, but maybe what they need to see or perhaps want to enjoy is that Kumasi Asante Kotoko are able to get a lot of goals without the response. It's 1-0 for Kumasi Asante Kotoko here at the Babayaro Stadium. They know that a slim win wouldn't necessarily be the right approach to the second game back in Tunisia. They really have to work deep and score a lot of goals if they need any chance of making it, the Porcupine Warriors. Habib. Very quiet after the goal that the fans are looking for a second. At least that would calm them down. I know that they have to be working hard because the Etoile side, a very technically gifted team, if they have a chance of moving forward. Scott O'Connor Jordan. Oh, lovely ball to pick up Abege. Well, that's a classic defensive play. It's now Jeffy. Jeffy looks to go in. Goes to ground. The referee says no. That is not a penalty. We're looking for that decision from Kumasi Asante Kotoko, the Liberian official Hassan Kone says no. Here comes Etoile. Jeffy. And it's going to be a card here. There's a yellow card flashed out to Meha Hanichi. Jordan. Kumasi Asante Kotoko 1. Etoile Sportive du Sahel nail. Habib Mohamed. Play. Jordan. Looking for another play. But again, he's been headed back into the goalkeeper by Meha Hanichi. Play there from the goalkeeper. Means Kotoko really have to restart the play. Here comes Hanichi Meher. And that trying to push forward. There's going to be the North Africans Gonzalez pushing the ball to Sadion, to his goalkeeper Makre. Play. That's it down. Well, so the scoreline really reflecting Kumasi Asante Kotoko's efforts, at least in this game, and are looking forward to see what happens. Another header here from Patrick Yeboah. Abege. Here comes another poor play, and Kotoko will lose possession in midfield. They picked it up again by Jordan. And still Kumasi Asante Kotoko struggling to keep up possession. They've been clipped in midfield. Ajman Bedu to Habib in defense. Justice Blay. Chance well. Okra. It's Kumasi Asante Kotoko on the move. Da Costa. Poor play, and Kotoko will lose the ball again. Still Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And struggling to win possession. Kumasi Asante Kotoko have a free kick here. Well, this is a game that fans are expected to see a lot of play here from the Porcupine Warriors, to see exactly if they still are the lethal team to get a win. Jordan here, Ampim Da Costa. Play. Patrick Yeboah. Jemfi. Emmanuel Jemfi. Spreads play to the far side. Here comes Jordan. Kumasi Asante Kotoko. In the box. And here they are. The Porcupine Warriors. Jemfi. Heads it down. And not the best of play. Yeboah. Advertising the cross. And it's been blocked here. Kotoko looking for a handball decision. Not given. Yeah, that's going to be a foul. That's the scoreline once again. It's back in 1966 Champions League game quarterfinals. Kumasi Asante Kotoko at home lost to Stade Abidjan. Joseph Blaziri scored the match winner there. And then back in 1969, it was Kumasi Asante Kotoko 5, Patronage Saint Anne 1. It was the Champions League second round as well. So we're seeing the Ghanaian side working hard to ensure that they still keep their momentum up here in the Champions League performance. They want to qualify and play in the group stages. But the odds are a very big task for them here. As this game against Sportif Etoile, Sportif du Sahel. Well, there we go again with another break in terms of set pieces there for the North Africans. They've had players in Kumasi Asante Kotoko who've come in. They're still looking forward to one of the most entertaining matches they have. But the difficulty here has to do with the North African opposition they have. Well, and the fact that they are meeting a side that have a lot of theatrics up their sleeves. The fans are not comfortable with a slim lead here. Yeah. Looking forward to see if Kotoko winning by a lot of margins. Jordan bitten in mid-air by Salim, and here comes Malek. Poor play from Malek. Jemfi picks it up. It's now going to be Patrick Yeboah. Okra push the ground. Well, again, it's been a very, would say, impatient game from both teams. Jordan and Kumasi Asante got to have up him da Costa. Hits this one, a bigger in. A diving header comes out. And now Habib finds support in his goalkeeper, Felix Sana. Ejiman Biru all alone here looking for support. Justice Blay. Jordan comes in for a pass. It was a very poor one there. And so that ends the first 45 minutes of the game. Kumasi Asante got to go lead by a goal to nil. And we're coming back in the second half. Maybe a way to get more in the game. Half time, Kotoko 1, Etoile Sportive du Sahel 0. But Jemfi has been working hard. Habib. Ampim da Costa. And he loses possession. It's not going to be the turn of Hamza. Lifts it down, finds Salim. Salim's ball, and ball has been pulled away. Poor play there from Malek. The 2-0 now for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Well, it's going to be a foul here. There's a yellow card to Augustin Okra for that foul. There's a foot-high challenge to captain Ben Unz Ahmed. That's another shot here. Was it missed there by Tafari Anis? And Kumasi Asante Kotoko still looking to see what it can do exactly to the Etoile side. Well, when it comes to the sporting club, Etoile du Sahel has sections of handball, volleyball, judo, and wrestling. Is a sporting club, and so it's understandable when a club is called a sporting club, they have judo, handball, and wrestling as part of the sports that a club is noted for, with a strike that comes out from Salim and picked up by Felix Annan. Abege. Jordan. Wednesday down for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Ajman Bedu. Here comes Justice Blay. Long one forward for Augustine Okra. Okra picks it up. And now it's going to be a throw in here. Trying to advertise a long one into the box there. Da Costa. Abege. Abege picks it up. There's a foul here. Kumasi Asante Kotoko have a chance now to push forward. Well, scrambling, trying to claim momentum. And it's going to be Hamza here. Find support on the left-hand side. And Kumasi Asante Kotoko would have to find a way to deal with this ball. Here comes Hamza. Well, again, there's a ball push too much there for Okra to pick up. Abege tried to find a way to redeem himself with a pass. Jordan. It's Jordan Opoku. Justice Blay. Yakuba. Trying to push the ball forward. And here comes Ampem Da Costa. Kotoko keeping possession. The Tunisians in their own area. And the ball is intended for Yakuba. And it's Yakuba again. And two players of Etoile Sportive du Sahel down, and Yakuba feels he did nothing wrong. So it's 2-0 for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And it was Sportive du Sahel having found a way back in the game. Ball into the half of Kotoko. Habib Mohamed heads it down. And again, it's another ball lost by Kotoko. Hamza. Finding support there in Karim. Karim. And it's a poor one there for Ariri Karim. And so Kumasi Asante Kotoko will be happy. At least the ball didn't really create any problem for them. Kotoko now having possession. Abege. Looking for support. He finds Okra. Here comes Ampem Da Costa. Back to Okra. Okra now moving. Spreading play. Ajman Bedu picks it up. Kotoko keeping the ball down. And now trying to move forward. It's Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Jordan Opoku. Orchestrating events in the midfield. Augustine Okra. And looking to a delicious pass. Patrick Yeboah sends in another one. As we head it back, Okra goes to ground, not able to get that volley that he expects so much. For a second, Abege beaten by Hamza. Kotoko wins it back again. And now they're trying to move again. Kumasi Asante Kotoko, Jordan. He finds Emmanuel Jemfi. It's going to be a throw-in against Marcia Sante Kotoko. Ajman Bedu with the ball back to his goalkeeper. Of course, the fans were having a heart in their mouth there. They thought that he's given the ball away. Here comes Jordan. Once again, the conductor, Sonia Yakuba, gets a return. Yakuba. And it finds another one. It fires it, but a very poor one. He's been in the treatment room for a long, long time, a very long time, so... It is particularly understandable if he's trying to keep his form back in the team. Hamza here. Oh, lovely play. And here Kumasi Asante Kotoko have a beam to their rescue. The center back pushing forward. Emmanuel Jemfi. Abege in here. And Kwali has been intercepted. And now it's Yakuba. He picks it up here. Yakuba looking for support. Nobody there to his rescue. He's been blocked. And now, Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Jafari. And Jordan again. To the rescue of Kumasi Asante Kotoko. What a game here. Emmanuel Jemfi. Jemfi. He gets a free kick. Now Kumasi Asante Kotoko with a chance here. Well, Kumasi Asante Kotoko looking forward to picking this one here. And they would ought to leave it down for Augustine Okra. And Okra already has scored from a set piece. So Ben Abis Faraz apt for Janal Anmar. Janal Anmar is in. And Okra with a chance to see if he can get a second here. Augustine Okra. There's a poor one taken from him. And Kotoko would have to get Ajman Bedu to deal with the situation. Ball back into their own half. Ampem Da Costa. Emmanuel Jemfi. He's always looking to run with the ball. And it's Kotoko here. Habib. In control, Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Well, looking forward for a third. And ball taken away from them. It's a foul by Justice Blay. Free kick. into the half of Kumasi Asante Kotoko here. It's been well defended. Patrick Yeboah was looking to deal with his ball. He wins it, wins a free kick as well. Kotoko making a change. Is Emmanuel Jenfi out for Kelvin Ando? It's a poor play. Kumasi Asante Kotoko giving the ball away. And now going to Justice Blay, who gets it out of Abege here. A lovely touch there for Abege. August Nokra finds Yakuba. Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Here they come again. Kelvin Ando. Da Costa. Abege is the target. Very poor one. And Abege couldn't quite get to the ball. And so it is going to be Kumasi Asante Kotoko winning back possession. And Ajman Bedu was a little bit over-elaborating there. But Kotoko have been very much quiet, keeping the ball. Well, the fans have been asking. Well, the header there from Kelvin Ando. And it's a goal kick. Ampim Da Costa here. Kelvin Ando trying to get a team moving. Jordan Okra is the target. Okra picks it up, hits it, only as far as goalkeeper Bidrik Makrem. So this game is looking like Kumasi Asante Kotoko looking to sit pretty good here with a two-goal lead going into Tunisia. It's always going to be a very difficult one. With a third goal, they think they're secured. But here comes the Tunisians, who have really been able to produce some bit of an excellent play. But the flag up and offside. Throw in to Etoile Sportif du Sahel. Two players of Kotoko just going in there and missing some bit of an opportunity. Well, it's going to be an injury situation there for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Ajman Bedu coming in to rescue them. Changes made there by coach Zakirasin. Tactically, Kumasi Asante Kotoko bringing in another striker. And also ensuring that they want to get another third goal by Kelvin Ando's introduction. But so far, haven't really created the magical change of direction and a magical way of getting the advantage into a third goal. Etoile have had some difficulties in the second half. Just happened in the first half as well. Haven't really created some chances. Kevinando, Abege here. Yakuba. A lovely play here. Abege. Yakuba waiting. Abege. Abege again. And he shoots wide. Yakuba was waiting in there for a pass. What a chance. What a chance again for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Hamza, Justice Blay. Now Etoile controlling the midfield, and Kumasi Asante Kotoko I want to find themselves in all sort of trouble here. Lovely pass, another poor play, and that came in from the captain. Ben Owens. Here comes Okra. Ball in the box now. It's a corner kick. And so here we go. Kumasi Asante got a good chance. And so the Porcupine Warriors are looking forward to making a third goal. Punched away. And a chance comes in. Blocked away. Another corner kick decision for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. The Porcupine Warriors lead by 3-0. Still not satisfied. Looking for a third goal. Near post. And here comes the shout. And then two players over 12 would have to go down, lay their bed, and take a rest. This is by far one of the toughest tests Kumasi Asante Kotoko facing in this competition, especially when they're here. And at home, they know that the task is not complete. And so the game is still on. And so the fans have really come in your numbers here at the Babayaro Stadium. This is a game Kumasi Asante Kotoko have loved so much. What a game they have. And yet again, against Etoile du Sahel, they know that they have to come in. Well, as Akiri Karim Was down. It's being treated. There's one centre forward. Hasn't really come into the game, has he? And so they waiting patiently to see if he's well treated. So it's Master Santi Kotoko leading by a goal to nil. On the bench is Hatch Hassan Yazim, a goalkeeper. And as the Porcupine Warriors are really much enjoying the support of the fans here at the Babara Stadium. And so Hatch Hassan Yazim is making his way into the game. If the referee doesn't want to have him in, Kumasi Asante Kotoko here. There's a change that has to come in here. And so it's going to be the center forward who's making way. Justin Hampson Hazem. Kuba here. Justice Blay. Okra keeps it in play. Ampem da Costa. And now Kumasi Asante Kotoko trying to start the game again from the defense. Yakuba is in there. Well, Justice Blay, and we're going to do additional time of 5 minutes. Ball taken quickly. Hazem. Kumasi Asante Kotoko back again. And then Kevin Ando. Pushing forward, Kevin Ando. Good play, Kevin Ando. It's been pushed down. And Kumasi Asante Kotoko have a free kick. Yellow card to Bogota Said. Bogatas gets a yellow card. Kevin Ana pushing forward. Well, it's Kumasi Asante Kotoko who have a free kick here. But there's still going to be an opportunity there for the Porcupine Warriors. And a change. Jordan is out for where in comes Godfrey Siama, scored a free kick against Connor Pillars back in Nigeria. Kumasi Asante Kotoko, Sonia Akuba behind the ball, Gas Nokra also there. Essiama also behind the ball. And the fans of Marcia Santo Kotoko waiting to know what happened here. We're doing 5 minutes of additional time. Kumasi Asante Kotoko with a free kick. And here comes Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Looking for Yakuba to pick this one. Where it goes up. And that's a wasted effort. Yellow card to the goalkeeper, Pedri Makrem. Kumasi Asante Kotoko, Etoile du Sportif du Sahel. It's 2-0 for the Porcupine Warriors. Looking forward to see if they can get a third goal before moving down to Tunisia. Kelvin Ando gets a free kick. Here they go again. Kumasi Asante Kotoko have another free kick here. It's a Siama. And here comes the Porcupine Warriors. It is Essiama. Send the ball in. Yakuba. And again, it's another wasted ball. Very much comfortable with the decision that at least they have a two-goal deficit in Accra, Ghana. The North Africans. Particularly going into the second leg. Yeah, looking forward to see what exactly they can do to ensure that they can have an opportunity as them here. Ball off the line. Kotoko. Here comes a pass here, taken away from Blay. Backward possession. Here comes Kelvin Ando. Ando trying to charge forward. Nearly pushed down. I beg it here. And again, Kotoko clearly losing possession. And then they get it back to Felix Sanon. Here they come, Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Lovely pass there from Felix Sanon. And here comes Essiama. And it's too much of a game that...